Hey everyone, welcome back to the shop. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I designed and cut this trivet. So stick around.
So I've got Inkscape opened up here. If you guys aren't familiar with Inkscape, it is a free program. It allows you to open any file that you have or design any file you want from scratch. You can come in here, you can tweak it. You can resize it, scale it, break it apart, group it together, whatever you want to do to design your file. Once your file is designed, you can save it as an SVG, and then that's what you actually import into Easel or whatever program you're using, and that's what you will cut with. So for this trivet, I want it to say the bees. So you come over here to the left side. You choose the font cursor. The font that I'm actually going with here is called Cooper Black. Click over here in your work area. Now, the easiest way I found to do this is just import all of these as individual letters. And that way, when you adjust these, they all can be adjusted separately. So now that I've got these brought in, I will start adjusting all of these. So go up here to the left, click your cursor. You can see that the B here now is highlighted. So I can drag that, I can get that, I can blow it out that way, lift it up, drag it. So I'm gonna go something like this. The S, I want to do the same thing. I'm gonna enlarge that and kind of pull that out a little bit. Then I will drag these together. Now, when you drag these together, you don't want to lose the actual shape of the letter. If I go something like that, it is hard to tell that that's an S. So if you pull that out, you want to leave as much shape as possible, but also you want to make sure that these are touching plenty so you get plenty of support so none of these break apart. Now, as I'm looking at this, I don't like the fact that the B and the S are italic. So I will come back to font. I will make the B and the S just bold. There we go. I like that a lot better. So I will come back over here to the S and I will make sure that these are just touching. And I like that. You can definitely tell that's a B and an S. I've got support right here for the tail of the S and I've got plenty of support right there. And now all I have to do is do the word the. So I will bring this over, kind of rest it there. I like the way that looks. Now the H is going to be a little tricky here because I want to make sure that I have two places of support. So I do, I have support right here and support right there. You can definitely still tell that that's an H. Now I will bring the E over. And again, I don't want the E to go right there because you do lose a little bit of the profile of the H and the E. So I will kind of set that right there. I'll make sure that space stays right there. Then we can definitely tell that this is a T-H-E. So once you've got this all adjusted and you got this looking exactly how you want it, take your cursor. You want to make sure everything is highlighted, and it is. Come up to Object, Group. And now you can see no matter where you click, you've got one file here, one piece. Now, in order to import this into Easel, it still is going to want to read this as a font. And in Easel, you can't import fonts. So what you have to do, there's a little workaround. You have to keep your file highlighted the way it is. Then you just want to hit Control, Shift, and C. And you can see right when I did that, my cursor, it got one of those thinking bubbles on it for half a second. That meant that I now copied this file to my clipboard. So now we'll go over to Easel and import that. I've got Easel pulled up here. I've got the dimensions of my workpiece in here, 12 by 10 by 3/4. So now it's time to import that file. So come up to Project, Import SVG, scroll down, find your file, Now it's going to say Easel can't import SVG text. It's going to say Inkscape, select all objects and use the keyboard command Control Shift C. We already did that in Inkscape. So if I hit import anyway, it should bring this in, no problem. There we go. I will resize this. I'm going to stretch this out just a little bit to fit my workpiece here a little bit better. Now, as you look at this, all these here are separate boxes. I've got five separate boxes. So if I choose cut on shape path, you will see there's all these intersections. And if you look over here on the right, that is not going to look right. That is not what we want. So we come back over to this left side. We want this to be a pocket. Then we come up here to edit. We want to combine. So now when you click anywhere in here, you can see this is one box here. This is one file now. It's exactly what we want. So now we can come back over to cut. Cut on shape path. And there we go. That's our cutout. It's not going to do any of the pieces here where they overlap. It's just going to treat this now as one cutout. So one thing to keep in mind is all these pockets in here, these little areas in here, in the B and the T and the H, the E and this S, when those get cut out, those pieces are going to be loose. So you can use the glue and tape method, or you can add tabs. On this one, I'm going to just go with glue and tape. So I'm going to get rid of the use of tabs because I will keep all this intact. And I don't have to worry about anything coming loose and breaking my bit. The bit that I chose here is an eighth of an inch. That's pretty decent. I know a 16th inch bit will definitely break if this piece breaks loose and rubs up against the bit. But I think with this eighth inch bit, I'm okay. I've got this set up pretty much how I want it. As I was looking at this and thinking through how this CNC was actually going to cut, this part of the H right here is super narrow. And that's the only piece I have connecting this other half of the H and the E to the rest of this file. As you can see on the T and the S, there's plenty of support there. These pieces aren't going to break off. And this part of the H, and this part that's connected to the T, that's also supported nice. But this actual piece is a little bit thin. So I can either recreate this file, choose a different font, but I actually really like the way this looks. So I'm going to highlight this, bring up the apps, scroll down to offsetter, and now I'm gonna just create a piece that's gonna sit on the back here. I don't need to keep the original, and I will bring this in. Now, just to make sure that both of these are aligned correctly, I will center to material, click out of that, make sure that I have the other one, center to material, and now this is exactly how they're going to look. Now, as you look at this, you've got this little spot here and this little spot here. That's not needed. So we can go ahead and delete that. Delete the other one. Then we can come up here, same thing to the H. We don't need that. So now as you look at this, you've got plenty of support all the way around all these letters. And now this small spot right here on the H is now supported by this back piece. So the actual script here is going to be walnut and purple heart. I've already prepared that piece. And now this back piece, that's going to be cut out of quarter inch maple. And I think once these are all glued and sandwiched together, it's going to look awesome. So now that you've got this all set up, you will just save this as you normally would, bring it over to your CNC and cut it out. So I've got this all finished now, guys. As you can see, the maple stands out real nice against this purple heart and walnut. This piece up here adds plenty of support for the H. You can see how thin that is there. But now you've got all this maple in there as support. Then those small pieces that were there and there in the maple are no longer there. So now, as you look at this, you've got real good detail. You've got a lot of depth here. This is going to be a trivet, so you'll just set that on your counter, put hot pots and pans on it, but something tells me this person is not going to use this as a trivet. This will probably end up going on their wall, but my intention was for this to be a trivet. I finished this all with food safe mineral oil, so can't wait to give this to her. Gotta wait till Christmas, but I think it's going to be great. I think she's going to love it. If you guys learned something from this video and you took something out of it, please give me a thumbs up. And until next time, take it easy.